Hey, did you ever finish that armor piece I needed?
What part was that?
The pauldron for my armor.
Who are you again?
I'm Big Red.
Sorry, all of you space marines are like 3D printers. You're all basically the same, just different colors. Do you really do anything that's that different?
I guess you're about to find out.
3D printing is something that I talk about a lot, but I mean, it's what got me into this hobby in the first place. I've told the story before, but I had heard that War Machine was starting to 3D print their models, and in my bad brain, I thought that means they're going to start putting out files so people can 3D print their game. And what I thought that meant was that I would be able to 3D print, you know, basically my own Warhammer army and play the game and take it to like events. I thought it was this whole big thing. Later, I found out that that wasn't the case. They were actually just going to be 3D printing the files themselves, and it wasn't going to be something that became accessible anywhere else. But it got me into War Machine. It got me into, you know, tabletop gaming altogether, and I bought a 3D printer, you know, because that was kind of like the last kick that I needed. And so after that, you know, I've been printing and doing tabletop gaming stuff for the last year now. And finally, I have a company that was like, hey, we got this new printer. We'd like you to take a look at it and let us know what you think. And so I thought, let's do it. I would love a new printer. Mine is, you know, a year old at this point, and it was the cheapest printer that I could find at the time because that was all I could afford. So I thought, yeah, let's get an upgrade. Let's see how it goes. And so that is what today's video is about. With that being said, I didn't want to come at this as like, I have all these 3D printers, let me tell you about it. You know, I wanted to kind of hit this at, is this a good starting printer? Because that's what it is. Okay, Anycubic sent me their Photon Mono 4. It is their starting grade printer. Right now, you can pre-order it. It's $189. Okay, so it is a starting grade resin printer. And so I wanted to hit this as a, if I was brand new to printing, would I buy this? What would, you know, be good about this for somebody who's just getting into the hobby? So that's what I did. Before I get into any of the good and the bad, right? I wanted to talk a little bit about the slicer. The Anycubic slicer is a lot like all the other ones. Slicers are all pretty similar. Sure, they have some added bells and whistles here and there, but overall, any of them work. I like to default to whatever company I got my printer from, but my original printer, the Voxel Lab, yeah, that wasn't going to happen. So I ended up using Chitubox, which if you don't know which one to use, it's a great, easy one to start with. But the Anycubic one is pretty similar to it. So go with whichever one you want. They're all pretty similar. There's guides to them out there. Don't get hung up on the slicer. Okay, so what do I like about this printer? There's actually a lot. This has been a great printer for me because anytime that you can get something, pull it out of the box, pull off the shiny plastic and things like that, pour in some resin and hit print and it just goes, is a good thing. And I felt like that's what this printer was. I felt like this printer is very easy to use, easy to set up. There's not a ton. I mean, it's just the same stuff, right? You plug it in, you fill it up, you level the tray, do that before you fill it up. You level the tray, fill it up, and then you print the file. And I printed the test files, and the test files came out great. One of them is even a calibration file that kind of helps you find out if you're printing exactly the way that you want. Okay, so they include that, which is nice, but obviously you can find them online too. So that's not a huge deal. But for me, easy setup is huge. I love being able to just pull it out and go. Another one of the really cool things is that this printer came with a screen protector. It came, you know, with the ability to just throw that on really quick, especially on brand new. If you ever put a screen protector on a phone, it's so much easier to do it when it's brand new than after you've had it for a while. So it's nice that they had that included and you could just throw that on. And what does it protect it from? Honestly, it protects it mostly from spills. So if you spill on it, anything like that, worst case scenario, you just pull off that screen protector and you get a new one, which will save you a lot of money in the long run. But with that being said, In the year that I've printed, I've only ever spilled on my screen one time.
It was a nightmare.
So, I mean, as long as you're doing things the right way, you don't necessarily need it, but it's always nice to have that assurance. Another one of the things that I really liked about this printer is that it has little pilot holes drilled right above, well, right where the vat goes. Okay, and the vat actually has screws that stick out of the bottom that slide into those holes. So there's no, oh, did I put it in far enough? Is it all the way back? There's none of that. It slides right where it needs to go, and then you just secure it down, which is awesome. But the thing that you don't think about too much is that every time that you take the vat out and you have to put it down, you have to put it down on something, usually the FEP sheet that is inside the vat sits flat on whatever surface. And that's super scary because you don't want it to get a hole. You don't want anything to happen to it. And so this comes in with a built-in, like, granted, it's only an eighth of an inch, but it keeps the whole FEP sheet an eighth of an inch off of whatever surface you're putting it on, which for me was like, that's so nice. So I loved that.
It's a game changer.
The build volume is a little bit bigger than like a standard printer. It's not a ton bigger, but the vat holds a lot more liquid than anyone that I've done before. Usually I'm pouring liquid in and then I'm coming halfway through a print just to make sure there's enough in there. I don't have to worry about that so much with this one because I feel like it holds so much. And so I really liked that about this printer. And it's a 10K printer, okay? And a 10K printer on a screen that's this size, that's really high density of pixels, which just means that it prints very clear, very cleanly. And I printed a few things out with it since I've gotten it. You know, I did the test prints, but I also printed a couple miniatures because that's what I do, you know? And they turned out really good. I love how they all turned out. Keep in mind, a lot of how prints turn out is dependent on the resin that you use and things like that, but overall the print quality was the best that I've ever dealt with. You know, is it on par with Games Workshop or other companies like that? It's pretty close. And if you dial it in and get it even more accurate, then I would say yeah. With one layer of primer thrown on these, you can't even tell that they have layer lines, which for me was a huge deal. So, what makes it bad? Why wouldn't you buy this? As an entry-level printer, it's cheaper. I mean, the second you pull it out of the box, the whole casing is plastic. The lid doesn't have anything to kind of secure it in place, and so it just kind of moves around a little bit. Which, I mean, honestly, once you get it on there, and you're fine, right? It's not that big of a deal. But it doesn't feel secure, which to me is just kind of like, well, why not? You know, they could have put a little groove around the edge just to make it secure, and they chose not to. The build plate itself doesn't really have a handle, so you basically unscrew it from the top and just slide it off, and you just kind of have to hold it by the fixture, which a lot of printers are that way, so it's not that big of a deal, but I do like kind of having a handle, especially with something that's going to be dripping resin and things like that. So, game-changing? No. Neither of these things so far are. They're just little nitpicky things that bother me, and you, as a new printer buyer, may want to know. You know, the chances of you dripping are pretty high in this hobby, and so, you know, just make sure when you're holding on to it that you do it in a way that it doesn't drip so much because you don't have a handle to hold on to. Now, next, the thing that I absolutely have to talk about is this. This is the spatula for removing stuff that comes with the build plate. This is a weapon, and I know it's a weapon because when I was trying to remove stuff from the build plate, it stabbed me. It stabbed me. Which, I mean, if you're looking at my hand, you can see I am not very good with knives, so pity me. And speaking of pity, if you'd like to pity me in my channel, please drop a like below, drop a comment, let me know what you think about 3D printers, and let me know what you think about your first 3D printer, especially. But please like, comment, follow the channel. Click that subscribe button and keep on coming back so you can see the videos that we put out because, yeah, I love to 3D print, but I also love to do just about everything tabletop related, and that's what we focus on here. So, spatula, death tool. A lot of them now come with, like, the beveled edges so you don't stab yourself. Those are way nicer than this. I'm probably actually going to bevel the edge on this myself with just, like, a little grinding wheel just to make sure that it doesn't happen again. But that also kind of goes to show one of the things that I didn't mention in the good is that the build plate itself is textured. And I have never dealt with a build plate that stuff sticks to like this. It is hard to get off, which is what you want, because then that means your miniatures aren't falling off. But this build plate is amazing, and it's textured on its own, so you don't have to worry about roughing it up yourself. It's just a really good build plate for stuff to stick to. But now, back to the bad stuff. I was talking about how cool the screen protector is, which it is, but it's also really big. And so it doesn't cover just the screen, but it covers about a solid, you know, inch roundabout, which is nice because then if the resin spills, it doesn't go down into the cracks in between the glass and the plastic. But at the same time, it's a static shield, right? And so it sticks to the glass plate because of static electricity, but everything around it is plastic, so it still doesn't stick to it super well. Okay, has that caused me any problems with my printing? No, hasn't caused any issues, but it's kind of like buying a screen protector for your phone that's just too big, you know? And so you have all those edges around the outside that if anything gets underneath them, it'll probably pull it off pretty easy, which again, maybe you want, maybe you don't. But for me, I just thought something they could have done better is a screen protector that was like sticking on the outsides or something, just to prevent that from ever having anything go underneath it unless you wanted to pull it off on purpose. But I don't know. I haven't dealt with enough of these printers to know if that's how they should be or if that's what people prefer. But to me, it was just kind of like, I don't like that so much. And in all honesty, that's it. I mean, I've dealt with 4 or 5 different resin printers, all of them entry level. And of all of those 5, this one's my favorite because you go in, you drop the file, you hit slice, it slices the file, you put it in, you hit print. Now, I do want to point out that with the Anycubic slicer, everything that I put in that was pre-supported, it said there was something wrong. Okay. And pre-supported files, there's not supposed to be anything wrong. They're supposed to be tested by the people who made them. So I said, don't worry about fixing them. And I printed them and they all came out great. So just kind of a little heads up there. But I want to thank Anycubic for sending this to me, for giving me the chance as a content creator to do something a little more. This printer has been awesome. Is it the best printer for somebody starting? Like I said, they're all so similar that there's just little things here and there that will make it the thing that you want. The price is great. The way things are set up on it are great. You know, if your printer's somewhere where the lid might get bumped off, you might want to go somewhere else just because the lid could fall off of this one pretty easy. But if it's in a nice, safe, secure spot, this is a fantastic printer for anyone looking to start out, especially for somebody who wants to get started printing miniatures. So that's my recommendation. And like I said, if you have any comments, any questions, anything that you would like to add, let me know what you think is the best starting printer. And let's stick to resin. I know there's FDM out there, and I know there's a lot of printers, and I love my FDM printers, but for this, we're just talking about resin. So if you could, drop me a like, let me know in the comments what you think about this printer, if you've ever used it, or other printers, or if you have any questions about printers in general, just drop them down below and we'll do our best to answer. And as always, thank you so much for joining us here at Pulsegate Games, where our goal is to make your tabletop experience the best one you can be. So get out there, print, enjoy your tabletop games, and as always, don't spend so much time building your world that you forget to spend some time in it. Until next time.